Hello everybody, welcome and welcome back. Today we're going to be playing on the best of three standard ranked ladder with a Sultai midrange list. Basically, this deck is looking to pressure a early invasion of Amonkhet with some 2-drops like in Teachings of the Kirin or a Mosswood Dreadknight. If you can successfully pressure this invasion, you're going to be up some cards and up a decent sized creature. If you can copy something like a Glissa or even a 3-fold Thunderhulk, you can make a 7-7 gnome and 7-1-1 gnomes. So the deck has some crazy curve out potential, and you have Urtai in here for counter magic, so if you play carefully, sometimes this deck is just very, very, very hard to lose with. We added in a couple Glissa Sunslayers as some other Invasion of Amonkhet hits, as well as a good creature to pressure the invasion with. Since it has First Strike and Death Touch, people aren't going to want to block, and you can remove 3 counters from the invasion when it connects. We run lots of early removal with Go for the Throat, Cut Down, and late game removal with Gix's Command to make sure our creatures are able to get through to the invasion, and late game to the opponent's face. This deck archetype is extremely resilient, and it's one of my favorite archetypes, so I'm glad it made it through into Lost Caverns mostly unscathed. If you guys are excited to see this in action, make sure to drop a like, leave comments, and make sure you're subscribed if you aren't already, as I'd really appreciate it. I upload to YouTube 5 days a week with standard content just like this, so if you don't mind dropping a subscription, I'd really appreciate it, as I'm still trying to get my channel partnered, and we're around 85% of the way there now. But with all that said, let's hop onto the ladder and see how this does. Alrighty, game one. Definitely playing first, and a land heavy, but we do have a Murex, and, you know, Dreadknight's pretty good. We'll keep it. Let's get down the Dreadknight. And looks like we are facing Domain. Let's get in for 3. And unfortunately, no plays here. And doesn't look like opponent has anything yet. Which is fine, because neither do we. Let's get in. And we will pass. And here comes a Chia Dino. Let's make a Mite. And in for 4. We can play Glissa post-combat, and we'll pass and can hold open Go for the Throat. So we've at least managed to mount a decent offensive. If opponent doesn't have Sunfall here, we'll be able to push through pretty much lethal. They of course do have things like Archangel to gain some life. But looks like they are going for the Invasion of Zendikar route. Okay. We'll take it. Let's get in with everybody. And think we just pass from here. We could have, of course, played the Shieldred. But if they had something like a Go for the Throat or Leyline Binding on their upkeep, then we would be leaving ourselves very vulnerable to a Sunfall. So I'm fine with leaving these creatures to die, making a Murex token, and then using Shieldred to force through the damage after the Sunfall. because we all know Domain. They always have the Sunfall. Well, there's Atroxa. There's a Sunfall. Oh, there's two. And that would go for the throat. Okay. Let's make a mite. Let's go for the throat. Yeah, GG's. And I think we will run it like that. The Cavern of Souls is a bit annoying, but can still hit Sunfalls. I think we're gonna try this. We're on the draw, so hopefully we find some sort of threat, but we do at least have ways to discard and some extra draws, and we have a bunch of mana lands. Krutai's not bad. Yeah, we'll play the Shores here. Just in case they have their Chiodino. Well, let's see what you got. Jeez. We'll take an Invasion. That's unfortunate. Let's go with the Invasion. And we draw our Thunderhulk instead of milling it off the top, which is pretty unfortunate. But maybe we just hit something like an Atroxa here. Archangel isn't terrible. Mosswood and a Sentinel. And they unfortunately didn't hit the right land for them to play anything, so... If we attack with a cottage, they go for the throat. But... Probably just want them to use that on that instead of the Shelly. Let's see if they let me attack. Okay, let's get a food. think we might have broken the opponent's spirit here. I'm sorry, Mr. Hippo. Yep, there's the go for the throat. And no more land. So we play Shelly here, the Leyland Binding. Next turn we frill back and blow it up. Still no land. So, unless they have another, you know, like go for the throat, the Vinestalk should be a pretty free attack here. That's gonna take my food before the invasion. Okay. Well, now we have a couple pretty good frillback targets as they discard a herd migration and grab a forest. I mean, let's gnome the opponent. Did you draw another white for a Sunfall? Invasion of Zendikar works. Let's draw the Dread Knight. Also pretty good. In that case, we can just play the Dread Knight and hold open Disdainful Stroke. And we will pass. And they name Angel, so is their last card an Atroxa? Because we got two go for the throats. Let's animate the Vine Stalk. And we'll go like that. Everybody in. And we'll make you a 3-3. And according to my math, that is lethal. GG's. Not too bad. Alrighty, next game. Definitely playing first. I think we can keep it. Being on the play with this at least is decent. We have these sentinels, which if they resolve, are going to get value. And same with the invasion. And looks like mono red. Well, wish this came in untapped. Or dinosaurs. Okay, we'll take two. Let's go with our sentinel. And down comes the hammer skull. We do get another land. I think we go for the throat on hammer skull. We can play the dread knight and get in for three. We'll take two. I see. So that was their plan. They wanted us to take two, and then they could kill off the sentinel. As is, they can take out the dread knight, which is fine. Let's draw. No land. That's not ideal. Do we go with the maps or teachings? I think we go with the map. Nope. Oh boy. Let's get in. We at least have a go for the throat if they do something like land a Drakasaur. Cool. So even though we never got to five, still was fine. For dragons. What's the last cut? Maybe one of the invasions. Alrighty, next game. I mean, sure, why not? We at least have Dread Knight into the invasion. And you have a dino? I was gonna say a mana dork, but looks like they are leading with Bushwhack. Good three drop. Let's get down the Dread Knight. Scytheclaw Raptor. That should be fine. Let's go with the invasion of Omenket. We'll send a three at the invasion. Cool. Down to one. Means it's going to be pretty easy to flip with that next turn. Okay. Okay, so opponent says screw it. They are getting in for 8, and we can have a 4-4 Glissa. Honestly, I respect it. Let's play a Sentinel. So they probably have something like their Triumphant Chomp to deal 4 damage to Glissa. Otherwise, I don't really see why you would let me have it. Unlock the Raptor. And we're at 6 life, which is definitely not ideal. Let's play the Cottage. And we're gonna pass. We can hold up an Urtai to counter, or we can kill the Raptor. Oh boy. So we have to counter that. Wait, no. Can't counter that. So we're gonna have to kill it with the Urtai. And now they can have their eggs. Take our block. Let's go with our Shores and play a Dread Knight and a Teachings. Explore. The Hatcher turns him into 3/3s. We'll just go there. We'll keep it. Jeez. And guess we have 2. And unfortunately, we will pass. Opponent does have their Restless Ridgeline still. And they animate. Let's go for the Throat on the Ridgeline before they can give us something a boost. What's in the grave? Let's animate the Cottage. And I think we just start jamming. We'll exile the Hatcher. And we will pass. Sure. They definitely did that in the correct order, since we now cannot cut down the yearling. Let's go like that. And we'll activate the cottage. They're just in for four. And we will pass. Nothing from the opponent. I think we'll go to combat. We'll get in for six. And they take it. So we play our teachings. And we can kill the raptor. Let's pass, and we can eat a food. Sure. Nice. GG's. Not too bad. Good old 2-0. And a couple post-game thoughts for everybody. I love this deck. Not much has changed. The addition of Glissa is pretty cool. Glissa is one of my favorite creatures in Standard right now, so being able to run her makes me happy. She fits into this deck very well, and is a must-deal-with threat, so I think she's probably going to keep her spot in here. The matchups today were definitely some difficult ones, but I think the deck performed really well, and I think I at least made the handful of correct choices, so we'll take it. Thank you everybody for watching, I appreciate it. Like, comment, subscribe, and I will catch you in the next one. Peace!